Hey, EO Alive, I'm Bree Troutman. Welcome to the first news roundup of March, also celebrated as Women's History Month and the beginning of spring. Make sure to mark your calendars for March 8th, International Women's Day, March 17th for St. Patrick's Day, and March 20th for the first day of spring.
This is the Friday edition of the news roundup, brought to you by Grand Ronde Hospital and EO and I.
This week, we heard more from Carrie Brigiotti at the Center for Human Development about local COVID-19 information. Here is a look at what she had to tell Brent.
You know, one of the things that we've been talking about for quite some time is this phasing for vaccine. So, we've been in the phase 1A group for quite some time. And then obviously we started the phase 1B, and it's really helpful to have that on the screen in January. And right now, as of March 1st, we're in phase 1B group 5, which is people 65 and older. So, you know, anybody who is in that group or a group that came prior to that is eligible to get vaccinated now. The new news, I guess, is that on Friday, Governor Brown shared the next phases, which we've been waiting for quite some time. So as you can see on this form, there's a lot of detailed information, but you know, the good news is that now we know when anybody in our state will be eligible. So you can see that the next group will be what they're calling group 6. They will begin being eligible at the end of March. And that will include people that are 45 to 64 with underlying health conditions, which are outlined on the next page, certain classes of workers, people that live in certain settings. Again, this is all based on risk, like what people that are at highest risk for either contracting the virus or having serious or severe outcomes.
Catch the full interview right here on EO Alive TV. Local high school sports are finally back in season, and you can catch LHS games on Facebook and EO Alive TV and the LHS activities page. You can get the inside scoop from our very own Dodzy, who's here today with your weekly sports update.
Thanks, Bree. For sports this week, it's a big week, man. LHS games have started. We're streaming all the outdoor events that are at home on EO Alive TV, on our Facebook page, on our YouTube, and on our website. You can also find them on the LeGrand School District website, their Facebook page, and LeGrand Athletics Facebook page. Man, this is exciting. It really is. EOU, there's news coming down the pipeline that possibly we're going to get some change in some of the spectator policies, and we might be able to get some fans in there. Stay tuned, man. Things are starting to open up a little bit, and I'm starting to get excited about it. This week was a busy week for me. Lots of different guests. Next week, I'm going to be featuring all the women's wrestlers at EOU that qualified for nationals. That ought to be really cool. As for Friday's show, today's show, I sat down with EOU basketball sophomore Preston Chandler. Have a little peek. Talk about your goals for this year.
I mean, personally, I just want to be able to contribute. You know, I think I look at myself as like a glue guy on our team who can score, rebound, defend, you know, kind of do a little bit of everything. You know, we're young, so just kind of stringing these young guys along and getting our team ready for next year. You know, that's kind of our ultimate goal. We're kind of looking at this year to develop and, you know, look to, I don't know, kind of form a togetherness of the team. You know, a lot of new guys compared to last year, so we're just trying to figure it out as we go.
Yeah, it seems like with coronavirus, especially with the basketball team, it's been like a revolving door. Like, there's been a lot of coming and going.
Yeah.
There's numerous guys that still had eligibility that aren't there anymore. There's guys that showed up for a little while and are gone. East Oregon, I appreciate you. Back to you, Bree.
Catch EO Alive Sports with Dodzy every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 5:30 p.m. Next up, come meet one of my special friends from Blue Mountain Humane Association looking for a home. You are going to love this guy. Hey, EO Alive. Bree Troutman here with Bear. Bear is what's called a bearded collie. He's still a puppy. He's just under a year old. He's freaking adorable. He's got this amazing, like, wire-haired coat. He's just a big bundle of energy, just super sweet, oafy, goofy puppy. He was brought to us as an owner surrender. Look at that face. I mean, he's just a doll. So if you're interested in Bear, give Blue Mountain Humane Association a call. Let them know that you want to check out Bear. And yeah, I think he's going to make a great addition to someone's family. He's just a super, super sweet guy. Yeah, you are. Huxitani Phil can step aside because Gabe the Weather Kid is here to preview next week's weather. Gabe, take it away.
I did originally predict milder conditions to take hold for this week, which we got, but I did not predict temperatures to become this warm. You see, the forecast modeling that I use to predict the weather sometimes have a difficult time predicting temperatures accurately in the middle of a major pattern shift, which we saw this past week. Temperatures starting off colder and then getting warmer. In fact, warmer than we've seen this year so far. The weather alert map is fairly inactive at the moment, an exception for this little patch over the Grand Ronde Valley, which indicates a wind advisory that will be extending through the next hour with wind gusts possibly as high as 45 miles per hour before winds will be on a decrease tonight with clouds on the increase that will make moisture develop tomorrow morning that could be anywhere from a mix of light snow to light rain through the Grand Ronde Valley, not forecasting any accumulating snow, but definitely can see that in the air before that continues through midday and then increasingly dry after that. Temperatures topping out in the low to mid 40s. We could see a few sun breaks to end the day tomorrow. Otherwise, anything that follows Sunday would be in the form of light rain. And as we continue throughout next week, I am forecasting temperatures to hold steady for highs in the low to mid 40s with lows in the mid to upper 20s. Generally, we could see times of a light snowflake or raindrop somewhere throughout next week. Otherwise, I think odds favor we remain mainly dry with a mix of clouds and sunshine. I think the nicest day next week will be Wednesday. Heading into the Blue Mountains, snowfall is very unimpressive as we are still starting out the next few days with not a lot of precipitation and still warmer than we usually see this time of year. So really only seeing anywhere from about a trace to maybe a few inches in spots, that's really only counting Spout Springs to see the most, even if you would call that in terms of snowfall. Heading into the northeastern valleys, I am tracking a mix of some scattered showers towards John Day and Baker City tomorrow morning. Looks a lot like LeGrand. Could see some snowflakes there in the air. Pendleton will be all rain. Otherwise, Burns, I think, will be drier. We could see some drizzle, though. But generally, as we progress throughout the next few days, I am forecasting the better chance for drier and sunnier conditions towards the southwest versus the northeast, edging towards the Blue Mountains, we'll see more of a system roll through. Temperatures generally in the upper 40s to low 50s throughout the next few days. This has been EOLive Weather Kid, Gabe Curtis. Hopefully all of you have a great weekend, and thank you to Nate Conklin State Farm Insurance in downtown LeGrand for sponsoring this video.
Thanks, Gabe. Stay tuned to EOLive for your daily weather updates. In our Brieflys this week, get ready to head to Wild Horse Resort in Pendleton at 8 p.m. on Saturday for the anniversary fireworks show. This event is free and open to the public, and everyone attending will need to stay in their vehicle, but it will be a great fireworks show. Get ready for your annual fix of fried food, farm animals, and fun entertainment. Union County Fair and Baker City's Miners Jubilee are back on schedule for this summer. The Fair and Miners Jubilee have both opened up applications for booths to attend. For more information, email the Union County Fair Board, UCF Event Coordinator @gmail.com. Call the Baker Chamber of Commerce for Miners Jubilee information at 541 523 5855. If you are looking for something more active to do on Saturday, head to Catherine Creek Snowpark for the LeGrand Snowdrifters Poker Run fundraiser. Participants will spend the day snowmobiling, poker hands up and down the hill from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. for $5 apiece for a chance to win a cash prize. From 5 to 7 p.m., members of the public can pick up a drive-through dinner of tri-tip or chicken tikka marsala for $25 apiece. Meal tickets must be purchased beforehand by calling the number below. For those of us hoping to stay home this Saturday, catch the Oregon East Symphony's Winter Chamber Series, Beethoven and Brahms live stream Saturday at 6:30 p.m. Tickets are $25 per household and can be purchased from the Oregon East Symphony website. Thanks for watching Eastern Oregon. I'm Bree Troutman. Be sure to tune in next week for the weekly news roundup.
Brought to you by EONI and Grand Ronde Hospital.